Hello, this is your daily dose of news from On Manorama. I'm your host Swati Ajit, and these are the major news stories of Saturday, December 23rd, 2023. A prominent Hindu temple was vandalized with anti-India graffiti in the US. The police are investigating the matter as a possible hate crime. The global governing body of wrestling stated that the Wrestling Federation of India, currently grappling with the sexual harassment scandal, has to ensure the protection of women wrestlers to have its suspension lifted. The United Nations Security Council took a crucial step by adopting a resolution in acknowledgement of the worsening humanitarian conditions in the besieged Gaza Strip. A Nicaragua-bound plane that took off from the United Arab Emirates carrying 303 Indian passengers has been grounded in France over suspected human trafficking. As the Nava Kerala Sadas entered Thiruvananthapuram for its finale, clashes erupted between the Congress and the police officials. Let's get into the details. A prominent Hindu temple was vandalized with anti-India graffiti in the US state of California, and the police are investigating the matter as a possible hate crime. Officers responded and met with temple leaders who described the vandalism as meant to intimidate them. Based on the content of the graffiti, it is believed that the defacement was a targeted act and the vandalism is being investigated as a possible hate crime, the statement said. The Consulate General of India in San Francisco strongly condemned the defacing of the temple. According to images posted on social media, the word Khalistan was spray-painted on a signpost outside the temple along with other objectionable graffiti. Newark police further said that any acts or threats of violence, property damage, harassment, intimidation or other crimes motivated by hate or bias are considered very serious and given very high priority. Khalistan supporters have increased their anti-India activities after the death of Canada-based Khalistan Tiger Force Chief Hardeep Singh Najjar. India's consulate in San Francisco in July came under an attack from Khalistan supporters who tried to set the diplomatic facility on fire. The Wrestling Federation of India, battling sexual harassment scandal, may need to safeguard women wrestlers to get its suspension lifted, the game's global governing body said on Saturday. The Wrestling Federation of India was suspended by the United World Wrestling in August after failing to hold its election on time. The UWW had asked for a fresh election after WFI's then-president Brij Bhushan Sharan Singh, a ruling BJP member of parliament, was charged with sexual harassment and criminal intimidation. Sakshi Malik, India's lone female Olympic medalist in the sport, has quit the game in protest, while Olympic medalist Bajrang Punia has returned Padma Shri, one of the country's highest civilian awards. Conditions to address the concerns about safeguarding could also be requested, a UWW spokesperson said when asked about the possibility of lifting the suspension on the WFI. We are still gathering feedback from representatives on site to determine if the conduct of the election was valid and well organized, the spokesperson said by email. The United Nations Security Council on Friday adopted a crucial resolution considering the deteriorated humanitarian conditions prevailing in the besieged Gaza Strip. Through the resolution, the UN demanded an immediate and unhindered delivery of necessary aid throughout the war-torn coastal enclave. The Council also urged the establishment of conditions for a lasting end to hostilities in the current Israel-Hamas conflict initiated after Hamas's unprecedented attack on Israel on October 7. About 70% of those killed in Gaza are women and children, and the war is the bloodiest in the country's 75-year history. The draft resolution was proposed at the UNSC on Friday by the United Arab Emirates, and the 15-nation council voted after days of delays. The resolution was adopted after 13 members voted in favor. None of the members stood against it, while the United States and Russia abstained. The resolution demanded that parties to the conflict allow, facilitate and enable urgent, safe and unhindered delivery of humanitarian assistance at scale directly to the Palestinian civilian population throughout the Gaza Strip. In this regard, the World Organization called for urgent steps to immediately allow safe, unchecked and expanded humanitarian access and create the conditions for a sustainable cessation of hostilities. A Nicaragua-bound plane that took off from the United Arab Emirates carrying 303 Indian passengers has been grounded in France over suspected human trafficking, French authorities were quoted as saying by the local media. According to a report, the National Anti-Organized Crime Unit has taken over the investigation. Special investigators are questioning all those aboard, and two people are in custody pending further examination, the Paris prosecutor's office said in a statement. The report says the prefecture said the plane had been due to refuel and was carrying 303 Indian nationals who had probably been working in the UAE. After landing in France, the passengers were first kept on the aircraft but then let out and given individual beds in the terminal building. The entire airport was cordoned off by police. The prosecutor's office said an anonymous tip signaled that the flight was carrying people who could be victims of human trafficking. Passengers were eventually transferred into the main hall of the small Vatry airport where cots were set up for them to stay overnight on Thursday. Clashes erupted between the Congress and the police officials in Thiruvananthapuram on Saturday as the left government's month-long outreach program, Navakela Sadas, reached its finale. The Navakela Sadas is set to conclude in the state capital today. The opposition Congress protest marched towards the Kerala DGP office became violent as demonstrators threw stones and sticks at the police. In response, water cannons were used to disperse the crowd. The march, organized by the Kerala Pradesh Congress Committee, aimed to protest alleged police atrocities against its workers during their agitation against the ongoing Navakela Sadas's outreach program of the left government. Violence has been reported from many places since Friday after the Navakela Sadas entered Thiruvananthapuram district. Violence was reported from Attingal, Katakada, Neyattinkara and Kuttichal, among other places. In many places, after the Congress workers waved black flag and jumped in front of the cavalcade, the DYFI CPIM workers allegedly attacked them. That brings us to the end of this episode. Thanks for listening to Daily News Dose, hosted by me, Swati Ajit, and produced by Vishnu Murlitharan, with technical support by Idea Brew Studios. Follow www.onmirab.com for detailed updates on the latest news, and be sure to come back tomorrow.